fingers get a little
Can I
stiff.
Brag on you? Can I just tell the folks
no,
at home? Because you're behind
don't.
the scenes so much. Mm-hmm. Among others, this man has played on hits by Brian White, Faith Hill, Shania Twain, Joan Diffie, Alan Jackson, Brooks and Dunn, George Strait, Trisha Yearwood, Patti Loveless, and that's just a few.
We even have Shania's new album. I mean,
it's,
you're on that.
You're all over.
You're all over.
I guess. I haven't listened to it unless they took me off of it.
Now,
that's possible.
What is one of your most famous licks that you really, really like to play?
Okay.
That people would easily recognize.
All right, well, here's one. Here's
all right,
one.
Got it.
See if you can recognize this.
You brought in and you put this down on a track for like Alan Jackson and then his band, they learned the song that you basically helped create in the studio, is
right?
That?
Yeah. Yeah, we're in the studio and we're just basically we come up with some licks. You know, he said, give me some kind of a Cajun-y lick, so I'll play a little bit of this, and Alan and I sat down together and we come up with that, you know. I had a lot of extra notes in it that Alan made me take out, but he said, oh, I think that's too many notes.
You're showing off a little bit too much. Well,
I simplified it a little bit, and it came out like that.
That's amazing. That is simplified. Well, I know there are a lot of people out there, including me, who are just trying to learn how to play the guitar. So what do you tell people? Does it just take more practice than most people can stand?
Some bleeding fingers and a lot of hours.
I'm sure
it's a lot of practice. It takes you got to be really... convicted to learn how to play. You gotta know that's what you want to do. You gotta, you know, I woke up every morning and grabbed the guitar and would forget to eat.
You gotta have a passion
really,
for it.
Yeah.
Well, can you show them the album cover?
Yeah.
This is your solo debut, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
The very first album by Brent Mason.
Hot Wired. And we understand that you did one of the...
That's him.
Yeah, you did one of the songs so fast that you regret it. Is that right?
And I regret it. I got to play it all the time now.
Yeah, because it's so fast.
I recorded it so fast, now I got to play the darn thing.
You're talking about the title cut?
Yeah, Hot Wired.
Well, let's show how fast
it is. Like right now.
Yeah,
I got to play the thing.
Put it on the spot.
It was something like...
I'm amazed by it.
You're unconscious. I don't know how you do that. I mean,
and you know what amazes?
I screwed up a couple of notes.
Yeah, right.
I didn't notice, but you know what amazes me is that you don't have these weird facial expressions like a lot of guys do when they play.
Yeah.
You know, they bite their lip and they're twisting their face around. You seem
You got to hold your mouth right to play those lips.
you make it look very, very easy.
Well, I make some faces.
Can we relive the moment here, CMA night, when they announced Brent's name?
Brent Mason.
Actually, there's a weird face.
there's the weird face right there. So you have been nominated many times before. And so what does an award like this do for you? We know for the people who are out front, the Alan Jacksons and so forth, it gets them more dates, it sells more albums. What does it do for a musician to win an award like this?
Well, you know, actually, it's like the ultimate appreciation to get
interesting with all...
In South Carolina.
As the new decade arrived, the psychedelic era seemed to be drawing to a close. People were no longer tuning in and turning up in Haight-Ashbury. The bands moved on, the community splintered, and a new sound emerged that moved away from the experimentation of the psychedelic era. Once again, the Byrds had anticipated the trend with their 1968 album, Sweetheart of the Rodeo.
We'd already known that country influence could work in pop music. We'd heard the Beatles song Act Naturally, and I'd written Mr. Spaceman, which was a 2-4. Hey, Mr. Spaceman, won't you please take me along? I won't do anything wrong. Kind of a country-ish sound. And so we started going in that direction, and we decided to do an album in Nashville and hired some country guys to come and help us out.
Winter time, you ain't going nowhere.
The Byrds even appeared on the stage of the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville.
We went to the stage and we got out there and we played a couple of songs and people would yell, "Get a haircut!" You know, "What's the matter? Did your barber die?"